Hi there, my name is Fogodino Ojeju. Hope you are keeping safe. Hope you are using your hand sanitizers. Hope you are also using the face masks in order to ensure there's no spread of COVID-19 in the country. Our topic for discussion today is refraction. But before we go over to refraction in details, let's see the lesson objective for this lesson. By the end of the lesson, the student should be able to understand and explain refraction in their own meaningful way. Explain the laws of refraction, understand and explain refractive index, solve simple calculations, list and explain some examples of refraction in nature. So refraction of light. What is refraction of light? The next diagram will tell us basically what refraction of light means. So when you are watching this video, make sure you go through these notes or the notes I've given you before so that you understand what I'm going to discuss about refraction. So let's go back to the next slide. Now, this is the diagram of refraction. Now, in order to appreciate this diagram, just glance through the diagram. In order to appreciate this diagram very well, let me show you a video that will make you understand the diagram basically well. Okay, this is the video. If you look at the laser lights, it's coming at an angle. Look at the angle. Angle to the what? So the normal here, invisible ray or invisible line to this angle, not to the water. Now, if you look at this, when it is bent at an angle, there'll be a refraction inside the transparent, second transparent medium, which is the water. But if it is coming perpendicularly to the water, which is the second medium, there'll be no what? Refraction. There will be no bending of lights. Look at the laser inside. Look at how it's bending. This video is basically showing you everything that refraction entails. So let's go back to our slide. Now, from that video, you notice there was what? A laser of light moving from A to B. This is the laser. And this laser light, or any light at all, moving from A to B, is what we call incident ray. This is the incident ray. Now, this incident ray must be traveling at an angle to the normal. And that angle is what we call what, the angle of incidence. So inside the second medium, it will bend towards the normal. The bending of light is what we call what, refraction. Look at the actual direction the light is supposed to follow if it was not refracted. Refraction actually means what? Bending of any wave. But our main focus is what? Light. That's why we are using light as a what? As a wave. As a wave. Because light can also behave like a particle. But that is a discussion for another class. Now, let's continue our discussion. Our incident ray, AB, meets the second medium, which is optically denser than the first medium. Now, the two mediums we are talking about here is what? Air and glass. Refraction is noticeable, or basically, transparent medium. This first medium, which is our air or vacuum, is the first medium. This is the second medium, which is the glass. And if you look at air and glass, which one is optically denser? Is glass. If I'm talking of optically denser, what do I mean by optics? Optics means light. Because we are actually dealing with light, and light is entering into this material. That's why we're talking about optics, which means light. So this first medium, air is what? A transparent medium. Glass is a transparent medium. Water is also what? A transparent medium. So refraction phenomenon can be explained using all these mediums simultaneously together. So let's go back. Our light is traveling from A to B, refracted in the second medium, then it's coming out as what? An emergent ray. Now, our refraction is what? This light, BC, bending towards the normal. What do you notice when it is coming out? You can see it's bending away from the what, normal. It therefore means the angle of incidence is greater than the angle of what? Refraction. So our AB is incident ray. Our BC is the refracted ray, which is the main focus. Our CD is the emergent ray. Emergent ray means what? Coming out, the ray coming out. After it must have refracted, it comes out and bends away from the normal. Then this, our N, is the normal. It's an imaginary line showing the path of light, or the light rays, the path should have followed if it was not what incident at an angle. Then our D represents angle of division. The angle formed if the light was not refracted. Look at the extension of this dotted line, showing this was the actual direction the light is supposed to pass. But now the light has bended towards the normal. And what is actually causing refraction? The main cause of refraction is what? Is the change of speed. Light travels at 3 times 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second. That's the speed of light in vacuum or air. But when it enters into the optically denser medium means the medium is stronger. If you want to talk about optically denser, if you say a medium to which is glass, it's thicker or stronger than air. You are basically not using the right vocabulary in what? In physics. So the right vocabulary is what? You use density. When you want to compare two materials and say one is two material and say one is thicker than the other, then you don't use the word thicker, stronger, you use denser. That's why I'm saying optically denser. Optics for light, dense for what? Stronger. So common IQ or sense will tell us that glass is thicker than this, followed by water thicker than what? Air, and so on and so forth. So we can go through the video and understand. Let's go to the next slide. The following are the laws of refraction. The incident ray, the normal refracted, all lie on the same plane. For two particular media, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is a constant. This second law, this is the first law. The incident ray, the normal, the refracted ray, all lie on the same plane. The first law. This is the second law, known as Snell's law. Let's go back to the other slide. This is what it's talking about. The incident ray, this is the incident ray. This is the refracted ray. And this is a normal. All of them are acting on this particular plane, this horizontal plane. That is what the first law is talking about. So the second law is telling us that if we form a triangle at this particular point that involves this incident ray or incident angle, then we form another triangle at this what? Refracted angle or refracted, that's angle of refraction. Then the angle or the sine of angle of incidence over the sine of angle of refraction will give us a constant known as what? The refractive index. What is refractive index? Refractive index is just a number showing how much a material can bend what? Light. So the denser, the optically denser the material, the more it can bend light. So that is what refractive index means. So refractive index and the speed of light. Glance through. When you are watching this video, just glance through and make a quick reading of everything there. Then at the end of the day, refractive index will give us speed of light in vacuum over speed of light in the medium. We can also get another way of calculating refractive index. And what's the second method? The first method was what? Sine of angle of incidence over sine of angle of refraction. The second method is what? Speed of light in air or vacuum over speed of light in the second medium, which is the denser medium. Now let's go to work example. Given that the speed of light in vacuum is 3 times 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second, calculate the speed of light in ground glass of refractive index 1.52. Now, what was given to us? Parameter given to us, speed of light in vacuum, C represents the speed of light, 3.8 and times 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second. Refractive index of ground glass, 1.52. Now, using the second formula, n equal to c over v, make v the subject of the formula. Then at the end of the day, if you punch your calculator very well, this is your final result. Example two, the figure below shows a ray of light. This is the figure below, shows a ray of light incident at an angle of about 60 degrees to the normal. Then the question wants you to find the words, calculate the angle of refraction, complete the diagram. So our solution, I equal to 60 degrees, n is equal to 1.33, N represents the refractive index of the glass. A is equal to, our A using sine I over sine R, sine 60 over sine R equal to 1.33. If you make sine R the subject of the formula, you get a fraction. Then find the arc sine or the inverse of the sine of that particular decimal fraction you've gotten. Then you get 40.6 degrees. So the complete diagram is this. So when you get 40.6, you draw a ray representing the diagram that is going, and this is the refracted ray. But this is the what angle of refraction, 40.6, so calculated. Now, principle of reversibility of light. The principle of reversibility of light states that light rays travels along the same path if the direction of light is what reverse. Very simple. This is what principle of reversibility of light is telling us. This is the light moving from A to B, refracts inside the medium, that's a optically denser medium, then it comes out or emerges as CD. Now, principle of reversibility of light is telling us that if we reverse the direction and let's say the experiment was performed this way, CD to DC to CB, then to BA. Then light rays can also follow the same path, meaning if the ray has followed this direction, it therefore means we can also reverse the direction of light and it follows the same path. That's what it means. Who says that our experiment should only be in this direction from A to B, B to C, imagine a C to B? The light ray can equally change direction from D to C, C to B, and B to A. That is what that law or principle of reversibility is telling us. So, effects of refraction. What are the effects of refraction? Number one, apparent depth of the swimming pool. Apparent depth. So, just give you like 1 second to go through this. Or when you're watching your video, you pause. Let's explain with the diagram. Now, if we are talking about apparent depth of the pool, if you look at this diagram very well, you will notice that the ray emerging from this, the deep part of the pool is coming out, refracted, bending away from the normal. So if it's bending away from the normal, that will give us a kind of visual image. Now, have you ever been to a swimming pool and you look directly at that swimming pool and you notice that the depth of the pool is what? A bit shallower than it's actually supposed to be. What is the cause of such phenomenon? Because of that phenomenon is what? Refraction. If someone was viewing it directly and there's no refraction, the light ray will just travel perpendicularly to what? To this first interface, which is the boundary, enter directly, and you will see, let's say if this is a cone, you see it directly. But because the dominant ray that will be entering your eye are all refracted rays, then there will be a false impression of the false depth. The first step will move a bit. There will be a lateral displacement. That means there is a displacement, there is a shift upward. So that shift upward that your eyes will actually see is as a result of what? Multiple refraction of light. That is the dominant what? Refracted light, that will enter to your eyes and that will give you a false impression. And you see a visual image. What does visual image mean? Visual image means that image is what? It's not the real image. If that image was actually to be taken by let's say you want to take a photograph of such image, it won't appear on the camera, it won't appear on the screen. Why? Because it's a false image. That image does not exist. It's just like a kind of, let me use the word, ghostly image. So if you look at this diagram very well, we have the real depth, then we have the what? Apparent depth. So if we want to actually the refractive index of any material, it can also be calculated by what? Dividing the real depth by the apparent depth. So that means we have another kind of formula. We have three formulas now for what? Determining the refractive index of transparent material. And what are the three formulas? The first one is what? Sine of angle, N is equal to sine of angle of incidence over sine of angle of what? Refraction. The second one is what? Speed of light in air over the speed of light in the second medium, which is the optically denser medium of glass or water or so on and so forth. Then the last formula is what? Real depth over apparent depth. So the second effect is what? Bent object in liquid. It's basically the same principle. This is a rod bent from one side. If you view it from the other angle, because of what? The refracted ray. There will be what? A false impression. There will be something like a what? Another kind of image appear to be broken. From this diagram, you notice that when the rays are leaving the bottom of the what? Of the rod, they bend away from the normal also. They are not going directly. They bend away. That bending away is what will cause the what? The refraction. And that refraction will give us a kind of image that appears, or the image of the rock will appear to be broken. And you will see an image of anything you put, like a rod or a stick, it will appear as if that image is what, broken or bent. So that is another effect of what, refraction. So basically, we are saying if there is no refraction, no bending of light, then there will be no what? There will be no such image as a broken image of a stick. So refraction is very, very important as a property of the wheel, because without refraction, some of these phenomena will not be what? Very, very what? We cannot understand some of these phenomena. Let's go to the last one, formation of rainbow. Okay, formation of rainbow and mirages. Refraction causes the formation of rainbows and mirages. Now, rainbows are formed as a result of three phenomena, not only refraction. First, refraction. Second is what? Dispersion of white light, which we discuss in a much more later video. Then the last one is what we call total internal reflection. And what is actually called, where it falls, the actual cause of a rainbow is the tiny droplets of water that hangs in the air will form the optically denser medium that the light will pass through. So when the light passes through those tiny drops of water hanging in the air, they disperse the light. And then what, after that dispersion, then there will be total internal reflection. That total internal reflection will come out as what? Rainbow. Now, the next one is what? Mirages. Have you ever been traveling on a sunny day? Let's say you are the one driving the car, or you are beside of someone driving the car, and you notice some pool of water forming at the, or you see a pool of water like an image in your front. So what is actually causing that image? That image is called mirage. The actual cause of that mirage is what? Refraction, and also what? Total internal reflection, no dispersion. But the main cause of it is what? Hot air around the surface of the ground. When light encounters such hot air, there will be total internal, multiple total internal reflection. Those total internal reflection is what will go back to your eyes as what? A pool of water. That pool of water is what we call mirage. So that is basically what refraction gives us in nature. So that is basically the end of our discussion today. So I hope you understand what refraction means. That refraction is the bending of any wave, whether light wave, water wave, or sound wave, when they come through what? An obstacle. And that obstacle must be what? Transparent. So what am I saying? For refraction to occur or noticeable, the first, the wave, which is light as we are discussing, we travel at an angle, we travel obliquely to the normal. When it travels at an angle, it meets an interface, crosses the boundary, and when it crosses that boundary, it bends towards the normal. What causes the bending, like we discussed before, is what? The change of speed. So when there is a change of speed, or when there is an alteration in speed, there will be a change in direction, and that change in direction will be towards the normal. If it is traveling from a less dense medium to a more optically dense medium, it bends towards the normal. If it's traveling from a more optically dense medium to a less optically dense medium, it travels away from the normal. And some of the effects of refraction we talked about today is what? We talked about real depth and apparent depth. We talked about objects that are bent in what? Objects that are bent in material, why they appear bent in the second medium. So those are basically what we talked about today. So to meet again in the next class, keep keeping safe. Ciao.